Good morning, everyone. In today's class, we'll be discussing about another algorithm in greedy approach that is called as Dijkstra's algorithm. Dijkstra's algorithm. So this is also called as single source shortest path algorithm. It's also called as single source shortest path algorithm. So the problem is, we need to find, given a graph, we need to find the shortest path to all other vertices from one single vertex. We'll see how to solve that. So this is solved using greedy approach or greedy method. And greedy methods are used to solve optimization problems. Optimization problems where we require an optimum solution. An optimum solution. The problem says single source shortest path. So shortest, it means that this is a minimization problem. It's a minimization problem. Previous example, what we have seen, knapsack problem, it was a maximization problem because we needed maximum profit out of that problem. Here we require the shortest path or the minimum path. So it is called as a minimization problem. So greedy method says that we have to solve the problem in various stages, taking single input at every stage, single input from the problem at every stage, at every stage. So if you recall dynamic programming, there was one algorithm where we found all pair shortest path, and that was an algorithm for all pair shortest path algorithm. This is single source shortest path algorithm. So this problem can be solved for directed or undirected graph, directed and undirected graph, and both these graphs have to be weighted. Both these graphs have to be weighted graphs. You can use a directed graph or an undirected graph, but make sure that those graphs are weighted. We'll see examples for both. We'll also solve this problem for directed graph and undirected graph, and we'll see how to find the shortest path from a single source or from a single vertex to all other vertices. Right? So let's see. We'll take an example graph, an undirected weighted graph first. We'll solve it for undirected weighted graph, and then we'll go for directed graph, and we'll see how to find the shortest path from a single source or a single vertex. You can take any graph for that matter, and you can apply this technique, and you can find the shortest path from a single source. So I have vertices from 0 to 7, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I'll add weights to those edges. So this is a weighted undirected graph. So I guess all the edges are covered with weights. Yes, all the edges are covered with weights. So this is an undirected graph, undirected weighted graph. As you can see, there is no direction given to any of those edges. So the problem states that I am going to select any arbitrary vertex as the source vertex, and from that vertex I am going to find the shortest path to every other vertex present in this graph. Say for example, I have taken this 0 as the starting vertex, then I need to find the shortest path from 0 to 1, 0 to 4, 0 to 2, 0 to 6 and so on. Alright, so single source, shortest path to all the other vertices. This is what the problem says. So choose any vertex, any arbitrary vertex as the starting vertex. You can choose 0, 1, 3, 6, 3, 7, 5, 6, any of those. Alright. This is it. So I am going to choose this 0 as the starting vertex. So this is going to be my source. So this is my single source, one solitary source from where I am going to find the shortest path to all the other vertices. This is going to be my source. I am going to call it as U. Alright. So the path, is there a path from 0 to 0? The first step is I need to find the distance from that vertex to every other vertex. So from this vertex to itself, is there any path? No. So the weight is 0. The weight is 0 for this vertex. Right now we don't know what is the distance at every other vertex. So just put infinity symbol, because we don't know the distances yet from this source to the all other vertices. So just designate those distances as infinity. Now, this is my starting vertex or the source vertex. Now check how many other vertices are connected to this source vertex. How many vertices are connected? 0 to 1 and 0 to 4. Do I have anything else, a direct edge? Do I have a direct edge anywhere else? No, it is only from 0 to 1 and 0 to 4. So what is the distance or cost from 0 to 4? From 0 to 1, it is 4. Initially it was infinity, now I am going to change it to 4. Because 4 is less than infinity. Next, 0 to 4. 0 to 4, what is the cost? 8. So infinity is greater than 8, or you can say that 8 is less than infinity. So this is going to be changed to 8. Infinity is getting changed to 8. So the working principle of this Dijkstra's algorithm works on this formula. D of u plus cost of u to v. Okay. Distance of u. Now this is going to be my u, this is my starting vertex, and this is going to be my v. And I have distance of v over here. Okay. Distance of u, distance of v. Distance of u and distance of v. So initially this was infinity, because we did not know the distance of that particular vertex from this source vertex. Alright. The distance of u. What is the distance of u over here? 0. Plus. C is cost. Cost of u to v. Cost of vertex u to vertex v. What is the cost of vertex u to vertex v? 4. What is the distance of vertex v? Infinity. So which one is lesser? 0 plus 4 is 4. So 4 is less than infinity. So I am going to choose this minimum value. Why minimum value? Because I need to find the shortest path. Minimization problem. So since it is a minimization problem, I am going to choose the minimum value out of these two. So this is the condition. If d of u plus cost of is less than this, if it is true, then what do? D of V is equal to D of U plus cost of U to V. Cost of U to V. See here, in this case, distance of U is 0, cost of U to V is 4, distance of V is infinity. Which one is less? This is less. So 4. So distance of V is equal to distance of U plus cost of U plus V. So this addition was assigned to D of V. What was D of V initially? It was infinity. I have replaced it with 4. So from infinity it has come to 4. Similarly for this vertex. Similarly for that vertex. What is distance of U? 0. Cost of U to V. Now this is done. Now this is my V. Cost of U to V is 8. 0 plus 8. What is the distance of V? Distance of V is infinity. Which one is less? 8 plus 0 is 8. 8 is less than infinity. So assign this 8 to D of V. So remove infinity and put 8 over here. So this is the concept, or this is the working principle of Dijkstra's algorithm. So we need to apply this concept to the entire graph. Alright. So I have changed the value infinity to 8 here and infinity to 4 here. This process of changing those distances is called as relaxation. I have changed the value from infinity to 4 and infinity to 8. So this process of changing is called as relaxation. So I am going to relax the entire graph over here in the same manner using this formula. Let's do it. So this vertex is already visited, so mark it as visited. Mark it as visited. Now these are all the unvisited vertices. These are the remaining vertices in the graph. So I need to check from each and every source vertex the shortest path to the other vertices. Let's do it. Alright. So this is already visited, so ignore this. Which are the remaining? All these. So out of all these vertices that are present, which one has the minimum distance? Which vertex has the minimum distance? We have 4, 8 and the rest of them are infinity. So which is the least one? 4. Which is the least one? 4. So choose this vertex now. So this is going to be my source vertex. So this is my U. This is my U now. How many other vertices are connected to this using a direct edge? 1 to 2 and 1 to 4. 1 to 2 and 1 to 4. So let's take this first. So this is going to be my V. This is going to be my V. Alright. So from 1 to 2, distance of U. What is the distance of U over here? 4. Cost of U to V? 8. Add it. 8 plus 4 is equal to 12. 12 is less than infinity. Condition is true. So distance of V, make it as 12. Make it as 12. According to that formula what we have seen. Distance of U plus cost of U to V. Is it less than distance of V? Yes. 12 is less than infinity. Change it. Similarly here, this is another vertex which is directly connected to this vertex. Now this is going to be my V. Distance of U plus cost of U to V. Distance of U is 4, cost of U to V is 11. 11 plus 4, 15. Is 15 less than 8? False. So don't change it. Keep it as it is. Only if the distance is less, make that relaxation, make that change. So 11 plus 4 is 15, 15 is greater than 8, don't change it, keep it as it is. So this vertex is done now. This vertex is done. Fine. So leave this 0 and 1 check the remaining vertices which has the minimum distance. So I have 8, 12 and rest of them are infinity. So which is the vertex that I have to choose? 8, because this has the minimum distance. So which are the vertices that are directly connected to 4? 4 to 8 and 4 to 5. These are also connected. See here, 4 to 1 is also connected, 4 to 0 is also connected, but these are already visited, so I am not going to consider them. So only two vertices which I am going to consider is 4 to 8 and 4 to 5. Is that clear? So this is going to be my U and these are going to be my V's. Check. Distance of U plus cost of U to V. Consider this as my V now. Distance of U plus cost of U to V. 8 plus 7 is 15. Is 15 less than infinity? Yes. So change it from infinity to 15. Next. There is one more vertex connected to this. So this is going to be my V. Distance of U plus cost of U to V. 8 plus 1 is 9. 9 is less than infinity. Change infinity to 9. Any other vertex connected directly? No. These are the only two. So mark this as visited. Alright. Next. Now I have 9 over here. This is 6. The distance or the cost is 6. Alright. So these three are visited. Ignore them. The remaining vertices which has the minimum distance. I have 12, I have 15, I have 9. Rest of them are infinity. So which is the least one? 9. So this is going to be my U now. Which are the vertices connected to 5 directly? 5 to 8, 5 to 6, 5 to 4. I can't choose this because this is already visited. So it is going to be 5 to 8 and 5 to 6. Apply the same formula. Let's take this as V. Distance of U plus cost of U to V. Distance of U is 9. 9 plus cost of U to V is 6. So this is 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. 9 plus 6 is 15. What is the value over here? 15. So it is same. So don't change it. Do not change it. Keep that 15 as it is. If this value was less than 15, I would have changed it. So do not change its value. Keep it as it is. Any other vertex connected to 5? Yes, this one. Now this is my V. Distance of U plus cost of U to V, 2. Is it less than distance of V? Yes. 11 is less than infinity, so change this infinity to 11. So the distance of this vertex from infinity was changed to 11. Simple. So mark this as visited. I'm not going to consider this again. Alright, now I have the remaining vertices. Which one has the least distance? I have 12, 15, 11, infinity, infinity. Which one is least? 12, 11. This one is the least. This vertex is with the least distance. So consider this. So now this is my U. How many vertices connected to this vertex directly? 6 to 5, but this I can't consider because this is already done. 6 to 2, 6 to 3 and 6 to 7. Let's take them one by one. First consider this as V. Alright, so distance of U, this is U, this is V. Distance of U is 11. Cost of U to V is 4, 15. What is the distance of V? Distance of V is 12. 15 less than 12, condition is false. So don't change that. Keep it as it is. Next. This is my V now. Distance of U, 11. Cost of U to V, 14. Is it less than distance of V? Distance of V is infinity. Yes. This is 25. 25 less than infinity, it is true. 25 less than infinity is true. So change this infinity to 25. Yes. Change this infinity to 25. Next, one more vertex connected is this. So V. This is U. This is V. Distance of U, 11, plus cost of U to V, 10. Cost of U to V is 10. Is it less than distance of V? Distance of V is infinity. 11 plus 10 is 21. 21 less than infinity, condition is true. So change this infinity to 21. Change this infinity to 21. Yes. Mark this vertex as visited. Now this vertex is visited. I am not going to consider that. How many vertices remaining now? These many. Which is the least cost out of the remaining? 15, 12, 25, 21. So 12 is the least. Take it as U. How many vertices connected to it? 2 to 8, 2 to 3 and 2 to 6. I can't take 2 to 6 because 6 is already done. So it is 2 to 8, 2 to 3. 2 to 1 also is not possible because 1 is already done. So 2 to 7, let's take this. Sorry, 2 to 3, let's take this. This is U, this is V. Alright, so distance of U, 12 plus cost of U to V, 7 and distance of V, 25. 12 plus 7, 19. 19 less than 25, condition is true. So remove this 25 and assign there 19. Assign 19 over there. Next vertex, 2 to 8. Next vertex is 2 to 8. Next vertex is 2 to 8. Yes. Distance of U. Distance of U is 12. Cost of U to V, 2. This is U to V. This is going to be my V now. Cost of U to V is 2. Distance of V, 15. 12 plus 2 is 14. 14 less than 15. Condition is true. Change this 15 to 14. Change this 15 to 14. Any other vertex remaining? No. 2 to 8 is done, 2 to 3 is done. So mark this as visited. Mark this as visited, or that source vertex is done. I'm going to choose a different source now. So how many left? 19, 21 and 18. 19, 21 and 8. Sorry, 14. 19, 21 and 14. Which is the least one? 14. Which is the least one? 14. Any vertices connected to this 8? Yes. 2 is connected, 5 is connected, 4 is connected. But all these 3 are visited. All these 3 are visited. So I can't do anything. Just leave it as it is. Mark this also as visited. Mark that also as visited. Next one. I have 19. I have 21. I have 19 and 21. Which one is least? 19. So this is U and this is V. How many vertices connected to this vertex 3? 2 is connected, 6 is connected, 7 is connected. But these two are already visited, so I cannot do anything for that. There is no relaxation that can happen there. So which is left out here? 3 to 7. 3 to 7 is left here. So distance of U, let's apply the formula. Distance of U is 19. Cost of U to V is 9. Distance of V is 21. 19 plus 9, 28 less than 21. Condition is false. So keep it as it is, don't change. This is visited. Which one is left out? 21. Any other vertex connected to it? Yes, 3 and 6 are connected, but they are already visited, so nothing can be done. So all the vertices are visited? Yes, all the vertices are visited. Now, which was my single source? Which was my single source? This 0. So what is the shortest distance from 0 to 5? From 0 to 5 it is 9. 0 to 5 it is 9. Of course there is no direct edge, but there is an alternative route which we can use. So 0 to 5 is 9. 0 to 2 is 12. 0 to 7 is 21. 0 to 1 is 4. 0 to 1 is 4. 0 to 8 is 14. 0 to 3 is 19. So, single source, shortest path to the remaining vertices. So, this is the principle or working principle of Dijkstra's algorithm. So, this we have seen for an undirected weighted graph. So, you can take any weighted graph, a weighted undirected graph, you can assign weights to it and take any arbitrary source vertex. Here I have taken 0, you can take 4, 1, 2, 8, any of them, and you can apply this working principle, that formula, and you can find out the solution for it. I hope this is clear to you. I'll write down the formula again. Distance of u plus cost of u to v less than distance of v. So, if this condition is true, then distance of v is equal to distance of u plus cost of u to v. This is inside an if statement. This is the formula, or this is the working principle which is applied to this weighted undirected graph, and we have found out the single source shortest path to every other node. I hope this is clear to you. Next, we'll see how this works for a directed graph. Let's see how this works for a directed graph. You can take anything, 1, 2, 3, 4 or A, B, C, D. I need to give directions also, since it's a directed graph. So there is a direction from A to B, from A to C, and B to D. So have this direction E, and I have C to B. I have E to A and C to D. So this is a directed graph. I'm going to add weights to it. Think everything is done. Yes. So I'm just going to draw a table with vertices, how many are there? A, B, C, D, E. Here I'm going to say visited vertices. Visited vertices. So the first source vertex I'm going to take is A. So A to A is 0. Rest of the distances are infinity. So let's write the cost. How many vertices are connected directly to this vertex A? A to B and A to C. I can't take A to E because there is no direction from A to E. It is from E to A. So it is only these two vertices. So this is U, this is V. Initially they are all infinity. So distance of A is 0. From A to A is 0. A to B, 0 plus 10 is 10. A to B, so write here 10. A to C, this was infinity, it has changed to 5. Remaining will remain infinity. So this is 5, sorry, this is 10, and this is 5. This is visited now. Out of all of these, which one has the least distance? 5. So take over here, C, choose this vertex because it has the least distance among all of this. So see how many vertices connected to it, C to B, C to D and C to E. I can't take C to A because the direction is reverse and it is already visited. So C to B, let's find out. Apply the same formula, distance of U plus cost of U to V less than distance of V. 5 plus 3 is 8, 8 is less than 10, condition is true. So C to B, it was 10, change it to 8. So 10 is getting changed to 8 over here. C to D, 5 plus 9, 14, infinity getting changed to 14. So here infinity is getting changed to 14. I am not going to write this because it is already visited. C to E, 5 plus 2 is 7. So infinity getting changed to 7. Infinity getting changed to 7. Mark this as visited. This vertex C is visited now. So which one has minimum cost now? 8, 14 and 7. 7 is minimum. So choose this and put E, the vertex E inside the list of visited vertices. The list of visited vertices. So from E, how many vertices are connected? E to A, but that is already done. E to D, there is a direction. That's it. I have nothing else. So E to D, 7 plus 6 is 13. So 14 is changed to 13. 14 will be changed to 13. 14 will be changed to 13. Rest of the things can't do anything. So this is changed to 13. Next, which one is minimum? 8, 13 and 7. So sorry, this is visited. So between 8 and 13, 8 is minimum. So B. So B to D, 8 plus 1 is 9. So 13 gets changed to 9. 13 gets changed to 9. So this is 8. 8 is the vertex with the shortest or the least distance, A to D. So 13 is getting changed to 9 over here by applying that formula. B is visited. From D, there is no other vertex connected from D to any other vertex because all the directions are coming into D. So no change over here. Even this is visited. D. Distance of D is 9. Alright. So this is how you can draw a table or you can directly assign values like this. Alright. Now if I want to find the path from A to D, as you can see there is no direct edge from A to D. If I want to find the path from A to D, so what path will I take? So first let's start off with D over here. What is the minimum distance of D or what is the distance of D over here? 9. Go back to the previous row. Go back to the previous vertex. 9 and 13, they are different values. 9 and 13 are different values. Then choose which one is minimum out of these two. I went to the previous row, I checked the value of 9 and this previous row value, they are not the same. So come back here, so it will be D and D. Now I'm here, the pointer is pointing here. Next, go to the previous one. 8 and 8 is same. So no change will happen over here. Go to the previous one. 8 and 10, different values. So pointer will point to the minimum value present in this row. Which is that? C. Which is that? C. 5. Alright. Next, it will go to the previous one. Not same. Minimum value? 0. So I have the path now. A to C, C to B, and B to D. Let's find out. What was the cost over here at D? 9. Let's see if it is 9. What is A to C? A to C is 5 plus C to B. C to B is 3. C to B is 3 and B to D. What is B to D? 1. So 5 plus 3, 8, 8 plus 1, 9. The distance of D is 9 from the source vertex A. So this is how you can trace the path. We have found out the distance of D is 9 from the source vertex A. But what is the path that we have to take? You can do it with the help of this table. So I hope this Dijkstra's algorithm is clear to you. We have seen it for both undirected weighted and also for directed weighted graph. So take any example, apply that formula and solve it. Thank you.